Someone asked me if I'd tell this story a long time ago. It's a weird story. I was out in Los Angeles, and I was at a party with a very big Hollywood producer. And at that time, they wanted to make an elaborate CinemaScope musical comedy out of the Dewey Decimal System. And they wanted me to work on it. And I go out to the producer's building in downtown Los Angeles, and I walk into his elevator, and there are no people in the elevator, no buttons on the wall or anything. And I hear a voice say, "Kindly call out your flaws, please." And I look around, and I'm alone. And I panic, and I read on the wall that it's a new elevator, and it works on a sonic principle, and it's all sound. All I have to do is say what floor I want to go to, and it takes me there. So I say, "3, please." And the doors close, and the elevator starts going up to 3. And on the way up, I began to feel very self-conscious, because I talk, I think, with a slight New York accent. And the elevator spoke quite well. And I get out, and I'm walking down the hall, and I look back, and I thought I heard the elevator make a remark. And I turn quickly, and the door's closed, and the elevator goes down, you know, and I didn't want to get involved at that time with an elevator in Hollywood. But this is the strange part of the story that was the normal part. I have never in my life had good relationships with mechanical objects of any sort, anything that I can't reason with or kiss or fondle. I get into trouble with. I have a clock that runs counterclockwise for some reason, and my toaster pops up my toast and shakes it and burns it, and I hate my shower. If I'm taking a shower and someone in America uses his water, that's it for me, you know. I leap from the tub scalded. I have a tape recorder. I paid $150 for it, and as I talk into it, it goes, "I know, I know." About 3 years ago, I couldn't stand it anymore. I was home one night. I called a meeting of my possessions. I got everything I owned into the living room, my toaster, my clock, my blender. They'd never been in the living room before. And I spoke to them. I opened with a joke. And then I said, "I know what's going on," and cut it out. I have a sun lamp, and as I sit under it, it rains on me. And I spoke to each appliance. I was really articulate. And then I put him back, and I felt good. And 2 nights later, I'm watching my portable television set. And the set begins to jump up and down. And I go up to it, and I always talk before I hit. And I said, "I thought we had discussed this. What's the problem?" And the set kept going up and down, so I hit it. And it felt good hitting it. And I beat the hell out of it as well. I was really great. I tore off the antenna, and I felt very virile. And 2 days later, I go to my dentist in New York. I had gone to my dentist, but I had a very deep cavity, and he had sent me to a chiropodist. And I go into a building, Midtown, New York, and I have those elevators. And I hear a voice say, "Kindly call out your floors, please." And I say, "16. And the doors close, and the elevator starts going up to 16. And on the way up, the elevator says to me, "Are you the guy that hit the television set?" I felt like an ass, you know? And it took me up and down fast between floors. And it threw me off in the basement. And it yelled out something that was anti-Semitic. And the upshot of the story is that day, I call my parents. My father was fired. He was technologically unemployed. My father worked for the same firm for 12 years. They fired him. They replaced him with a tiny gadget this big. It does everything that my father does, only it does it much better. The depressing thing is my mother ran out and bought one.